What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video on the channel today. Hopefully you guys are doing well. And today, boys, we've got a video explaining how the Division Rivals and Foot Champ systems work within FIFA 22. This was probably one of the most asked questions within my stream over the past weekend, so I thought I'd bring you guys a video on it. Hopefully you guys find it helpful and informational. And if you do, don't forget to hit a big old thumbs up. And if you are new around here, don't forget to subscribe. If you guys look at the game modes for FIFA 22, they're pretty much the same as FIFA 21. However, Division Rivals and Foot Champs have been heavily reworked, and that's what we're going to try and go through today and hopefully explain pretty well. Now, I'm going to be starting off in Division Rivals because it's kind of the base for all of the other competitive game modes in Foot Champs. You can't really progress into Champs without playing Division Rivals, so I think it's the most logical place to start. And the first thing that you guys might see, the first big change, is that Division Rivals now has a season system. You can see Rival Season 1 ends in 44 days. Now, obviously, that's at the time of recording this video, and I think in previous years, we've had about 8 or 9 foot seasons, and they normally go for about 6 weeks. So these seasons coincide with the regular FIFA Ultimate Team seasons, and they should hopefully be going for about 6 weeks. I think this one's a bit longer because obviously the game hasn't come out yet officially. Obviously the Ultimate Pre-Order Editions have come out, but the actual like main release of FIFA 22 Ultimate Team is not quite out yet. So I think that's why that's a bit longer. And the main reason why they've implemented this is because realistically in FIFA 22, there's not really a relegation system. So the seasons kind of implements that relegation system, so it keeps the mode fresh across the year. Now, going into Division Rivals, as you guys see, right now I'm in Division 6. And the way that Division Rivals works this year is that you start off in Division 10, and then you have to play and win matches to progress yourself up the division ranks. Now, this is very different to how the start is in FIFA 21. In FIFA 21, what happened is you played your 5 placement matches, and depending on how you did in those 5 placement matches, you finished anywhere from Division 7 to Division 3. That's not the case this year. And then also on top of that, you don't actually get a coin bonus from progressing up divisions anymore. So when you finished your placement matches last year, you used to get a large amount of coins given into your account, because you got all the coins from Division 7 all the way up to whatever division you placed in. That's not the case this year, and unfortunately that means that you probably are going to have less coins from the starts than you did in FIFA 21. However, I think it kind of balances itself out because the buy power of the overall market as well is also not as high, so it's kind of somewhat even. Now, if we take a look at the progress screen, you guys can get a better idea of how the Division Rivals process looks overall. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go back down to Division 10 to kind of explain it a bit better so you guys have a better idea of how it'll work. So as you guys can see down at the bottom left corner, we have +1 for a win, -1 for a loss, and +0 for the draw. And what that is referring to is how many spaces you guys are going to go up or down if you go ahead and win or lose a game. Now, if you draw a game, you stay in the same spots. If you win, you go up one. And if you lose one, you actually go back one. However, if you're at a checkpoint, you can't go back past a checkpoint. So as you guys can see in lower divisions, you actually are pretty safe, and you can only really go up because every game has a checkpoint. However, when you progress up the divisions, and you guys can see now there's like blue dots in between the ranks, but there's not as many flags anymore, it gets a lot harder. And for me right now, I'm kind of stuck on Division 6 rank 2. You can see there's a flag right here on the rank 2 badge. However, I'm in a situation right now where I'm like winning one game and then losing one game. So I'm kind of stuck on this rank. So you need to win, for me at least, to progress to the next rank. I need to win 2 games in a row in Division Rivals, which is definitely getting a bit hard. And yeah, that's the kind of the way they kind of like limit your progress as you go through. Now, as the season goes on, what I expect will happen is that the majority of the player base will shift slowly upwards. So if you're finding a division quite hard right now, you're probably going to be able to do it a bit later, just as more players come into the division. That's just kind of how the way it works, because people can only go up during the season. They can't go down once they hit a checkpoint. And as you guys can see, like when we go up to the even higher divisions, there's like even more ranks in between stuff. So we've got situations here where in Division 4 and Division 3, we have to win 3 games in a row and potentially even 4 games in a row to kind of work up. Now you're thinking to yourself, yo, this might be a bit hard. 4 games in a row is quite a lot. And the way they've kind of also added this in, and if you're a good player, you can take good advantage of this, is through win streaks. So what is able to happen is if you're able to win multiple games in a row, and I might try to get a clip from my stream because we were able to get it on stream, If you are able to win a few games in a row, I think it's probably about 3 or 4, you will actually get a win streak and you can actually progress more than one step up at a time. So the highest win streak I've been able to get is a x2 multiplier. I would potentially say there might be a x3 multiplier if you're a very good player and you can win a lot of games in a row. But what it allows you to do is it allows you to progress up multiple steps at the same time. And that way you don't have to win every single game if you're a very good player. It makes it a little bit less tedious. Now let's take a look at Division Rival Rewards for this year. And the way the rewards are set up this year are actually very, very easy to understand. So the way it was last year is you had to progress up the ranks by playing games. You got points. And then depending on how many goals you scored, you got more points or less points. And the more points you had, the better rewards you got. And you weren't certain because the milestone wasn't like fixed. So you weren't certain if you're going to get rank 1 or rank 2 within a specific division. But the way they've done it this year is actually really, really easy. It's just based on wins. So if you get 3 wins in Division Rivals overall, so it's not even in that one specific division rank, whatever, it's just 3 wins at any point in time within the week, you go ahead and qualify yourself for rewards. And you guys can see the rewards are in 2 days, 15 hours. I think every reward period is every week. So that's kind of the way it is. But you guys can see that you qualify yourself for rewards. And then you can upgrade those rewards by winning 7 games across the week. So I think the objective for most people, if you guys are going to be playing Division Rivals, depending on whatever rank you're in, my best recommendation for you guys would be try to go ahead and get 7 wins at a minimum. So you're going to be getting this upgraded reward set. And you guys can see right here, we've got a Prime Gold Players Pack in Division 6 Rank 2 as well. So some coins. There's also an untradeable option with more coins. And then also like a combination of 2 with less coins. And what I'm actually going to have coming up on the channel later in the week, probably in the next couple days, is a Division Rivals Rewards video, what you guys should be choosing. So if you guys aren't subbed to the channel, make sure you go ahead and do that, subscribe, click the notification bell, you get notified when we go live with that sort of video. And hopefully I can help you guys out and give you guys a bit of insight into what you should be choosing. Now, the way that Division Rivals works is, if you guys are lower in the divisions, in the ranks, of course, you're going to be getting lesser rewards. And we can have a look at 7 wins for Division 10 Rank 2. And obviously, no one can actually get this because if you get 7 wins, you're going to be higher up regardless. But as you can see, the rewards aren't that crazy. Small Prime Gold Players Pack, as well as also 1,700 coins. Really nothing that crazy. You guys saw the Rivals Rewards Rank 6, which they're getting decent at that point. However, if we progress all the way up into the upper divisions, and if you're one of those better players, you want to get up here as soon as possible to secure these rewards every week. They're getting really good rewards. In Division 2, we're looking at 50k packs. And then as we progress into Division 1, we're looking at 100k packs. And even higher up in Div 1, Rank 1, you get more coins. Now, the cool thing, and the thing I didn't realize until I actually had a look at it, is there is one final division past this one. You need to win 4 games after you get into Div 1 Rank 1 in a row, or if you're on a win streak, you can kind of cut that down, to get yourself into the Elite Division. And the Elite Division is what they use this year to kind of rank competitive players. And there's actually an Elite Division leaderboard. We can kind of have a look at it in a bit. But the way that this works is, for the reward set, obviously, for 3 wins, you don't seem to get it. So you want, if you're in this division, you want to be getting at least 7 wins. Doesn't really matter if you win or lose the games, because you can't get relegated from the Elite Division once you're in it that season. But if you can get yourself into the Elite Division, you're actually going to be going ahead and getting yourself an additional red player pick. So you guys know that in Foot Champs, there is for rank 2 and rank 1, I believe, 3 red player picks. If you guys are good enough and you can get yourself into this Elite Division, you're going to be getting a 4th red player pick. So the main caveat of all this is that it is actually from Team League 1 to current. So I think it can be any player. So it might not be anything crazy. At least that's what it says right now so far. But we'll have to see how it all goes. You guys will want to be getting those extra rewards, and it's kind of nice to see. And then also on top of that, there's an additional like 100k pack as well as like 100k pack as well as some coins. So that's also quite nice. I don't think the comp scene has really been explained in that much detail so far this year, at least from what I've seen. But if we press triangle and take a look at the Elite leaderboard, this is what it's going to look like. Now, there aren't any players right now in the Elite Division because the game has just come out. But as you guys can see, you've got the rank, you've got the online ID, obviously the PSN or Xbox Gamer Tag. And then also on top of that, behind here, you'll see skill rating. And the way they base the top 200 and the Elite Division, how well you're progressing up and down in that division, is via skill rating. So it's quite similar to last year. That's kind of the way it is, but Unfortunately, I can't give you that much more information on that because there's just no one in there. I don't know if there's rewards tied to top 200, but for all you guys who used to finish top 200 in weekly rewards, it doesn't seem like right now there's anything equivalent to that, like 11 team the week pack. So, bit of a shame for you guys, but I do think that the rank 1 rewards this year are a lot easier to get in for champions. Now, also on top of that, one final thing for Division Rivals. I know it's been quite lengthy, but there's a lot to kind of go through. We do also have season milestones, and this is just how many wins you get throughout the entirety of the season. You're going to be getting better and better rewards. So, as you can see, if I'm in Division 6 and I've won 20 games, I'm getting a Prime Mixed Players Pack. Now, that's nothing too crazy, but if I progress myself up to 90 games, let me gain myself an 100k pack as well as also a Prime Gold Players pack. Now, the higher you are in divisions at the end of the season, you actually get better rewards. So you guys can see up here in Division 1, with 90 games played, you can actually get yourself 200k packs and then also a Jumbo Premium Gold Players pack, which is, I believe, a 24 player pack with 7 rares. And then also on top of that, for the Elite Division, if you're able to play 90 games across the season, you're going to be getting 200k packs and also a Rare Mega. So they are pretty decent rewards, but I don't think they're substantial enough that if you're in Division 6 or Division 5 and you played the same amount of games, you're really going to be missing out all too much. You're only just going to be getting like one or two less packs, which I don't think is that big of a deal. And then the final thing to mention about Division Rivals is that when the season ends, at the end of the season, depending on what division you're in, you'll actually get relegated to a specific division. We don't know what the whole relegation system is looking like, but they're gonna reset you a bit back down, and what that means is it just keeps the game mode a bit more alive throughout the year because there is no relegation system right now. Everyone could just finish in Division 1 rank, like Division 1 of the Elite Divisions by the end of the year, and they're all getting the max rewards. So it kind of resets you back down, gives you something to kind of play for, and then once you get to that top division or wherever you are for the end of the season, you'll get relegated once again. So that's kind of how the whole system works. Alright guys, so that kind of wraps up for all the Division Rivals changes, and now it's time to move over to Foot Champions. And Foot Champs as well has been heavily reworked this year. It's rather different to what it was in FIFA 21. So as you guys can see, we do have two separate modes in Foot Champions. We have the Foot Champs Playoffs and the Foot Champs Finals. Now, the playoffs can be played at any point during the week, so as long as you've got the champs points to kind of qualify into it, you're going to be able to go ahead and play the playoffs. However, the finals are only played during the weekend, and it's kind of the equivalent of last year's weekend league. As you guys can see, we have 20 matches down the bottom instead of 30, and the more wins you get, the higher ranks you're able to get. I believe rank 1 is 16 and 4, we've got 12 and 8, I believe this is 8 and 12, 4 and 16, and then you just have to play all your 20 matches to get rank 5. So the ranks are actually very easy to obtain. The main challenge is going to be qualifying for this Champions Finals overall. So let's go have a look at the qualification process and kind of give you guys a better idea. First of all, to qualify into the Foot Champs Playoffs, you have to play Division Rivals. As you play your Division Rivals games, you're going to be going ahead and getting yourself qualification points. All you guys have to do to qualify for the Champions Playoffs is to go ahead and get yourself 1500 qualification points. And I think as you go up the divisions, you actually get more points per game. So it should be relatively doable for anyone who's grinding out a decent amount of Division Rivals. You should be able to get the qualifications for the Foot Champs Playoffs. Now, the main concern that I have for this mode, and I don't know if it's going to kill champs overall, is if you look at the bottom left corner, we've got 7 champs entries remaining. That is quite concerning because I don't know, and I'll let you guys know down in the comments below with a little pinned comment if I do figure it out when I play it, and I'll figure it out as the game goes on. But that could either be 7 champs entries per week or 7 champs entries per season. And if it's per season, that puts a lot more pressure on this mode for you guys to go ahead and play, because you guys know that the best rewards in the entirety of the game is in Division Rival, is in Foot Champs Finals. We're looking at like 16 and 4, you're getting like 3 red player picks, 2 team week packs, but even like if you lose all your games, you're going to be getting 2 red player picks and then all these packs as well. So yeah, that's the main concern I personally think, is if you guys only have 7 entries per season, it means you can only mess up this qualification process twice, I think, maybe once, in the first season, if you want to play every single weekend league. I'm personally of the belief that if someone wants to go ahead and play in a weekend league, because it is quite a lot, and you can qualify for it, you should give them enough chances to qualify for it. If they're able to get the amount of qualification to get into it, then yeah, I don't think you should be able to limit that qualification process, like by limiting how many entries you have. So if that's the case, and it is every season, that makes it extremely, extremely sweaty, and I'm hoping that's not the case. But maybe that's how they want to do it, because the rewards are very pushed up, so maybe they just want to make it like a little bit harder to get actually into the finals. But anyway, that's about basically how you qualify into Foot Champs playoffs. And now let's have a look at the finals overall, and how you qualify into that. So as you play through the playoffs, you guys got 9 matches. You get 4 points for a win, 1 point for a loss. Once again, boys, you don't really want to be rage quitting out of games, because you're not going to be getting the points for a loss if you do rage quit out of a game. And you get 8 points if you go ahead and lose 8 out of your 9 matches. And you're going to be getting yourself 2 15k packs. If you progress yourself up to rank 3, I think you need to win 4 games, basically, or I don't know what the equivalent is, maybe 2 games, 7 losses. No, that's going to be just less. So you need to win at least 3 games. But if you win 3 games, you're going to be getting yourself a gold players pack and a premium gold players pack. So nothing too crazy for those two. And the main one that I think everyone's going to be trying to get for, because of course it's qualification into the finals, is you're going to need to win 5 games and lose 4. If you can win 5 out of 9 games, you guys are going to be able to qualify yourself for the Foot Champs playoffs. You're going to get yourself a 225k packs and also a gold players pack. But more importantly, and most importantly, you're going to be going ahead and getting yourself the finals qualification. So that's the main goal out of all this. And as soon as you get that token, you can then save that token for whatever weekend you want to play in, and you can go ahead and qualify yourself into the Foot Champs finals. And then of course for rank 1, there is a rank 1 up here, and it's just better packs. So mega packs, 2 red gold packs, 1 gemma gold pack. The main thing is, though, is that you guys need to try and get yourself into this rank. So if you guys are playing playoffs, make sure you get yourself 5 out of 9 wins. That's going to allow you to go ahead and qualify into the finals. And we've kind of gone over the rewards before in a previous video for the finals. But once again, the rewards are very good. Like, if you are able to get, I think it's rank 3, this is like 8 wins, 12 losses, I'm pretty sure. And you're getting yourself 2 what's called red picks, but you're also getting yourself a 100k pack and a team of the week pack. So it's a bit less than elite rewards, but for 8 wins, 12 losses, I think that's pretty alright. Alrighty guys, so that kind of wraps it up for the structure of Division Rivals and Foot Champs. Now a final few words before I wrap the video for today, and I want to give you my thoughts and opinions on the balance of everything and how the Division Rivals and Foot Champs systems are set up. I think qualification into the Foot Champs playoffs is fine with 1500 points. Seems very, very doable. I like the new Division Rival system. I like the fact that if you get 7 wins, you know what you're going to be getting in your rivals rewards. My main concern is qualification from the playoffs into the finals, and I really, really hope that that 7 down in the bottom left corner isn't reset seasonally, because the way I see it is, if someone's trying to get into their first weekend league for the first weekend, and you guys use up 6 of your 7 entries to qualify, but you finally get it in, you get 1 more entry for the rest of the season for every single weekend league. I personally think the way it should be for Foot Champs finals overall is if someone's able to go ahead and get that threshold of 5 out of 9 wins, then they should be able to play in the finals. Depending on how many entries you want to limit them to, I think 7 per week is more than generous. I could see 4 or 5 being very, very reasonable as well. But to give them 7 for the entirety of the season and then not able them to like play in that final bits, like for like another like 5-6 weeks in Foot Champs finals, I think you cap off a lot of your player base for a long period of time in Foot Champs, and you guys are not going to be able to get those reds until like the next season resets, and you might become a better player over like the 4 weeks gone by, but you then can't qualify. So once again, I'll let you guys know down in the comments below, or pin something if it is weekly or seasonally or what time base that resets, but I'm really hoping and praying that it is weekly and not seasonally, because I think it's going to make it so much harder to qualify for the finals, and then people are going to be like missing out on rewards, not because they're not good enough, but because they're just not given a chance to be good enough, right? So that's kind of the way I see it. Now, I don't think the matchmaking is going to be too hard for the Foot Champs playoffs. I can't see it being anything other than opened or something like DKT, where the more wins you get, you kind of match up someone with the same number of wins. I could see either one of those two kind of happening, but it should be relative. It's not going to be based on like your division rank. I don't see it being done like that, because it doesn't make sense for it to. And then also on top of that, the finals, I reckon it will be somewhat similar to last year's matchmaking with like a in a certain range. But yeah, I like the overall system of it all if it does work that way. My main just concern is just the FUTCHAMPS playoffs qualification into the finals. I hope they give people enough chance to try and qualify for those finals. But anyway, boys, that kind of wraps the video for today. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Hopefully it helps you out a bit to kind of clarify some of the things about FUTCHAMPS playoffs, FUTCHAMPS finals, and division rivals, of course, overall. And let me know what your guys' thoughts are. I'd be keen to know what you guys think of the overall system, what you think you're going to be able to do this year. Hopefully you're able to get into some final situations. And yeah, hopefully you guys are enjoying FIFA 21. I know the full game is out for the Ultimate Edition. If you haven't got the game yet, then hopefully you're able to get your hands on it soon. But anyway, boys, that's going to do it for the video for today. Take care. Have a good one. Much love. And peace. Whenever your heart is broken.